Dear Admiral, I am told you succeeded in protecting the star portal. Excellent work. Unfortunately, you cannot return to base just yet. We have received a puzzling message from the main Vardrag system. We have been unable to decipher its exact meaning. It seems that something is causing quite a stir. Before we could ask for clarification, the transmission was interrupted. Please, cross the star portal immediately and find out what is going on. Don't forget that Rob Scheinman is currently on a diplomatic mission in the Ring City. Bring him home immediately if you consider it necessary. We can take care of any diplomatic tensions later. For now, the most important thing is to find out what has happened. Oh, and Rear Admiral, have a safe journey.
It is only a segment of the entity, a landing unit, if you will.
Can we destroy it?
No, and doing so would achieve nothing. The planet is already lost.
That's it? The planet's just lost? How can you brush off the destruction of an entire planet so easily?
Warning.
Simple pragmatism, Commander. If I could do anything to stop the entity, I would have done so already. I could sing laments until the end of time, but it would not undo the damage or bring a single dead Vardrag back to life.
We are dead! We are dead! We are dead!
Let's show a little decorum and think about those who are still alive. Angel, how did the entity get here? I thought we stopped the mechanoids at the star portal.
It must have found an alternative route.
Wow! She's sharp!
If we scan it, we may find our answer.
Sir, we have identified the Vardrag ship, Sunrider. It is under attack by two other Vardrag ships.
What's so special about the Sunrider?
Vice Admiral Scheinman is on board as part of his diplomatic duties.
Damn it. Hail him on his private communicator.
Unit.
Rear Admiral. Our scouts report that they have detected some kind of space anomaly on the far side of the entity. They are unable to identify it.
Maybe this will answer our questions. Let's go and investigate.
Marcus, at last. You have to help. We are stuck aboard the Sunrider.
We'll do what we can. Hang in there.
Sir, the Sunrider has lost its IP drive. It cannot escape.
Target ship is being evacuated. Enemy unit found. Enemy unit lost. Target ship is being evacuated. Enemy unit found. Enemy unit lost.
Marcus, just in time, as always. I tried to convince the Vardrags to assist you.
Understood.
Ship is being evacuated.
Understood.
Enemy unit lost. Enemy unit found.
Affirmative. Affirmative.
In position.
Yes, sir. Affirmative.
Target hides special information.
Affirmative. What the hell is that? It looks like a wormhole.
Your analysis is mostly correct.
Mostly?
It is a wormhole, but it does not have an exit. Not in the traditional sense, in any case.
Analysis.
In English, please?
Calm down, Commander. It is difficult finding terminology that you will understand. The passage leads into subspace, a place where the concept of distance becomes nonsensical. The wormholes connect solar systems via subspace, but their entrances and exits are fixed. This hole, however, leads directly into subspace, to the Nexus. Imagine our galaxy is a sheet of paper. Its corners are far away from each other, so we have to travel a long way on this flat sheet to get from one corner to another. However, if we were to fold the corners of the paper and make them touch each other, then these points would become very close to each other, while still remaining distant points on the flattened paper. The space that surrounds the folded sheet of paper is roughly analogous to subspace. If we want to use subspace for travel, we have to know how to navigate once inside. We have to locate the point we want to travel to.
Yes,
just as important is knowing how to open a hole in subspace and exit. Established wormholes save us the trouble. All we have to do is fly through them.
All this suggests that the entity arrived from subspace and is able to open a wormhole anywhere it chooses. That explains how it managed to get here, even though we prevented the mechanoids from exploiting the Alpha Gate.
It has the power and the resources to conquer other worlds. If it is at all possible to defeat the entity, we must do so at all costs.
Let's find out more about this thing.
The sphere consists of thousands of mechanoids. The resultant creation is far greater than the sum of its parts. Its task is to conquer the Vardrag planet and integrate it into the entity. The entity itself is observing from subspace.
Do you mean that the entity can be present in more than one location at a time? Are there multiple entities?
There is only one entity, or rather, well, it's easiest to refer to it as a single entity. But it exists in many forms, and its objective is omnipresence. That is why it annexes sophisticated systems such as computer networks, laws of nature, or societal laws. Through these systems, it grows stronger, and it is spreading.
I think I'm starting to understand. But if the computer networks are the best substrata for the entity, why did it progress so slowly here compared with the speed with which it conquered Earth? Vardrag computer systems are infinitely more sleek and sophisticated than those on Earth. Surely they'd make an ideal medium.
As I have already said, computer systems are just one part of the picture. The systems on Earth were perfect for the entity, as if they were designed for it.
And you're saying that's just a coincidence, right?
I am sorry, Rear Admiral. I have no answer for this question. We have all the information we need. We can't do any more here. I advise that we leave.
Aye, aye, sir.
Enemy unit lost. Enemy unit found. bound. Complete. Scientific analysis complete.
Aye, aye, sir.
Enemy unit lost. Enemy unit found.
Affirmative. Understood.
Found. Warning. Shield down.
Yes, sir. Affirmative. Yes, sir.
Warning. Shield down.
Fall of Vardrags. The entity controlling the Earth is spreading. It has targeted the Vardrags' main planet. It sent smaller subunits into the system near subspace in order to occupy the planet. The gate through which the invasion entered is special. It does not lead into another solar system, but directly into subspace itself. We refer to this area beyond physical space as the Nexus. Cross of Cromwell, for extraordinary heroism in the action while serving as commanding officer of the Angel Wing Fleet near Chakras 3 Chakras system on December 13, 2112. Assigned the mission of collecting information on possible mechanoid activity in Chakras system, Rear Admiral Cromwell, displaying rare tactical ingenuity and inspirational leadership, skillfully directed the operation of his fleet. Analysis of the data he managed to collect during the mission about the entity sphere and the subspace distortion greatly contributed to our understanding of the operation and goals of the alien entity. Despite the alien environment and the extremely difficult circumstances, he managed to assert the position of Admiral Scheinman, then led a swift and brave action against the attackers of the Vardrag ship carrying the Admiral, assuring their escape from the mechanoid-infected territory. His superb leadership, fearless determination and extraordinary heroism under fierce battle conditions materially contributed to the successful accomplishment of the Angel Wing Fleet's objective, aiding the NOAA Defense Force's effort in the actions against the Mechanoids.